Blackstone presents Gears of War, Ephyra Rising by Michael A. Stackpole. This book is read by Nan McNamara. To the memory of Paul Garabedian, a wise man and a great friend, gone much too soon. Act 1. 1. Road to the Stroud Estate. Near Ephyra, Sarah. 11 Harvest, 18 after emergence.
Why, Marcus Phoenix, I do believe you are smiling.
Marcus wasn't sure what was more unsettling, the note of surprise in Anya's voice, or the fact that he actually was smiling. He shifted his rucksack, giving himself a couple of seconds to consider her words. Then he nodded.
I guess I am at that. Kind of scary, huh?
Anya Stroud, walking beside him on a thin strip of paved road, reached out and caressed his cheek.
I like it, and we'll get used to seeing that smile. You've definitely earned it.
A lot of us did. Earned the right to it.
Marcus fought to keep the smile alive.
But so many will never smile again. So many. Too many. Dom, my father.
He sought to push aside the darker feelings and tried to distract himself by looking around. But that did not help overly much. The roadway west from Ephyra had ditches slashed through it, as if something giant had raked it with claws. And while some grasses had turned golden with the coming of autumn, black swaths of burned vegetation twisted up and down hillsides. There wasn't a single spot where his gaze could rest without seeing signs of the war.
No. I am not ruining today.
Marcus reached up and took Anya's hand in his.
Smiling is easier when I'm with you.
I've missed you too, Marcus.
Anya returned his smile, her eyes bright.
I can't tell you how happy I was when you radioed to say you'd reach Ephyra this morning.
I was actually in the suburbs when I radioed. There just wasn't enough left for me to recognize where I was.
In the 6 months since the emulsion countermeasure had wiped out the Locust and the Lambent, the world had tried to heal itself. Grass and weeds grew again. A few trees actually blossomed, and some had borne fruit. It wasn't much of a harvest, and never would have been considered bountiful, save that so many people had died that humanity didn't have the hands necessary to harvest all that had grown wild. While the natural world could heal, what man had wrought simply could not. The damage meted out to the works of humanity had dealt a near mortal wound to civilization. Marcus had traveled throughout the countryside, in some places with isolated little farming communities, life that would have seemed normal for his grandparents still existed. In other places, refugees clawed out a Stone Age existence. And then perhaps 25 miles on, a single building might stand untouched in a town, complete with electricity and the other amenities that had once been normal.
Back when I was a kid. Even just back before Emergence Day.
He glanced at her.
How bad has it been in Ephyra? I know you've been helping Colonel Hoffman get us all squared away, but that can't have been as easy as you made it sound on the radio.
She shrugged. Took a bit of getting used to, becoming an XO again. Instead of a gear?
Once a gear, always a gear, Anya.
Marcus shook his head.
You were a gear even before you stepped into the field. That's why I always trusted you. I could always count on you, we all did.
And you always did the heavy lifting. She gave his hand a squeeze. Well, in the 3 months since I headed back to Ephyra, Colonel Hoffman and I shifted from trying to help what was left of the Cog army to just generally helping people. So many people feel abandoned and want to get back home, just to see if they have a home. We surveyed some blocks in the city, marked off the unsafe buildings. But people are alone and afraid of each other. Some of them seem
feral.
Yeah, I know. Marcus had been traveling widely in the last 6 months, helping gears return home. Some communities welcomed their returning soldiers and began organizing.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.